So welcome to Tony Watara Tuesday edition. We are doing the three circuits, three exercises, 50 seconds work for each exercise. I really want you to focus on your form, which I will constantly cue you and throw out there. And each time we go through that circuit of three exercises, we're gonna make them a little harder. But I want you to do you, so you stay where you're comfortable, but not comfortable where you're challenged, but still maintaining form. Once you break form, I want you to go back to that wherever you were, because that's where you'll grow your strength. And that's it. That's really it. We have those cardio. Hold on. We have those cardio bursts in the middle with the isometric hold. So I think that's it. I'm gonna go back here. We're gonna get started. I'm gonna press play. I'm gonna take a sip of water. I have to tell you what I'm doing. We're gonna have a 2000s playlist. Start off with some Christina, because you guys, you're beautiful. Take a big deep breath in. Right there, when you go into that play, I want you squeezing your booty coming up. And go back down one more time. Make sure you're inhaling and filling those lungs up with air, and then exhale one more. Good job. Roll your shoulders back. Roll them back. Loosen them up. They do carry a lot of the burden of a total body workout when we're on the floor. So we have to treat them kindly. And we have to make sure that we're in proper form. That protects them. Good job. Good job. Just send one arm over and reach. And we're going to come right back. We'll do a nice dynamic stretch. Switch to the other side. Just lengthening the muscle, come back. One more time, over. Each side. Good. I want you to take, activate your core, bring this knee up, circle it out. In and out, open up those hip flexors. A little balance challenge too. Squeeze the booty, squeeze the core. Your mind's doing your muscle. Not your mind, you only have one, it's not plural. Good job, other side. So out and in. Woo. Do what you need to do to balance. Good, opening up those hip flexors. One more. And I just want you to take a big side lunge, send that booty back. Come right back up, other side. Send that booty back. One more. Good job. We are going to go right into circuit one, which I love to start with that inchworm. So inchworm is hands above your head, fold over, walk it out into that high plank. Yesterday, we shoulder tap. Today, I want you to tap out in front of you. Tap. I want to reach. Tap it out. Just stay out here in this high plank and tap it out. I do not want your hips moving. If you find your hips are moving, I want your knees down on the ground. But I want you to have that booty squeezed, and your hands are directly under your shoulders, but your hips are not moving. Squeeze that butt. We are beautiful. Core engaged. Tap out in front of you. Tap it out. Good job. Walk it back up. Inchworm it back up. Roll it back up. And we're just going to do a squat. So this is your foundation moves. This circuit, this first time through, is all foundation. So then we'll build off of it. That squat, you are sending that booty back. Your chest is up. Your shoulders are down your back. As you send that booty back, you feel your weight should be in your heels and not your toes. Good job. And if this is where your squat is, that's fine. You work on it there, and then you'll just get lower. It's baby steps every day to get closer or stronger. Good job. Keep going. We'll go. The first circuit is always nice and like warmy, uppy. Good job. Squeeze that booty. Shoulders down your back. Good. Get on the floor. I want both legs up in the air. And I want you to cross and reach. If your lower back is bothering you, I want you reaching up. We're gonna avoid spinal articulation or just twisting it. So you are reaching across if your back is not bothering you. Shoulder blades come off the mat. Use your shoulders to find that energy to pull your shoulders and chest to pull your back off the ground. Cross it over. Get that lower back onto the mat. Good job. Get your mind in those muscles, because this is your basic ground. We're stepping it up. Next circuit, we're going to roll right into it. Okay, so we had that plank walk out. Walk it out. So if you take my classes, I like to bring things. I have things in class called sliders, and we slide out. Okay, so what I want you to do though, instead of slider, walk your hands forward until you're like, oh, I can't go any further, then walk them back. Okay, you're walking them straight in front of you. It's okay that they're not under your shoulders for this, because now we're going really deep into our abdominal muscles. So if you need to put your knees on the ground, totally fine. Walk your hands forward. Once you can't go any further, then you're gonna fall, bring them back under you. Keep walking them out. Good job. If this bothers your lower back, as you get further out with those hands, the muscles, you're using lower and lower muscles in your abdominals, and your back gets involved. So, bring it to your knees. Okay, let's hit those squats again. Come up to standing, people. I want you to hit that squat. You stay back in that squat. And I want a glute extension, come back up, down. Now I want you to show me some speed. Now we're getting into the meat of the workout. So squat, shoulders stay up, tap it back, up, squat, tap it back, good. Tap it back, stay low, fire up those quads. Knees engaged, navel to spine. Up. Shoulders are down your back. Eyes are forward. You don't need to look at the ground. They're looking straight ahead. Because they have to. Look straight ahead. Good job. Back down. Look at how fast this goes. Exercise three. This time we're scissoring our legs as we reach across. Keep that heel off the ground. So right here, and I want you to reach, reach, reach. Each scissor is a reach. So your lower back is pressed into the mat. Your shoulders are off the mat. Good job. Don't let those heels hit the ground. Reach it. Beautiful. Lower mat, lower back into the ground. That chest is proud still and leading that reach. Not your neck or head. Good job, almost there. And I got one more time through. Okay, so I'm staying right, stay down on the ground. I want you to come onto your knees, and I want you to walk those hands all the way out in front of you, and then lay gently on the ground. Bring your arms around, push it up, put those knees down, walk your hands all the way out in front of you. Walk them out. You can slide them out if you're on a slippery surface. Feel those lower abs ignite. Place yourself on the ground. Bring your arms around, push up. See how I snuck a push up in there? You could be on your knees, squeeze that booty, walk those legs out. This is like I'm trying to imitate an ab roller with you or the sliding disc. Wrap those arms around, push it up, back down to your knees. Slide those arms out if you're on a slippery surface. Otherwise, you walk them, use that core, squeeze it, squeeze it, squeeze it. Feel your lats fire up here. Push up. Good. I love that exercise. I would actually love to do that like 20 more times. Okay, squat. We have that squat glute extension. I might
throw that in there again. Squat, glute, jump. Squat again. Tap it back. Jump. Land like a ninja. Tap it back. Good job. You can do like little 180 jumps in there if you want. Tap it back. Jump. Tap it back. Good job. This is where the longer intervals, like, oh yeah. Keep those eyes up. Keep that navel to spine. Keep those shoulders down your back. You don't want to jump, you come up to your toes. Your knees bother you, you go to your toes. Good job. We have the via. Okay. Back down on the ground. So we did the scissor cross. This time, I want a via. So you are reaching. Try and really get that upper body off the ground. And crossing that arm over to the other side. If that's too much, scissor those legs. Go back to servitude, which was a scissor and a cross with your arms. Otherwise, we're tapping all our abdominal muscles here. And your lower back to get you off that ground. Good job. Good. Yes. That was circuit one. How fast did that go by? Okay. So now we're going to do, you have 20 seconds. Take a sip of water if you need it. I do because I talk a lot. And I also need to towel up because I sweat a lot. All right. We are going to do a little jumping jack combo for our cardio. So I'll show you. It's a regular jack out, and then arms just come up forward. Okay? That's going to be our cardio. We're going to do that 2 times. Let's go. Up. You can tap it out. I can't talk and do the forward jack. I want strong arms. I want strong booty. I want shoulders down your back. You're breathing. I love the forward arm motion. Like you're pulling something up. Really activate. You feel the lat activation, which I love. Because I'm all about those pull-ups, which are so suffering right now. Let's go. You got this. With my hold on this, keep down. Oh, just drop into a front lunge. Stay right here. So stay right here. 90 degrees on the front leg. 90 degrees on that back leg. We're staying on one side. So remember what leg is forward. We're here for 3 minutes. That's the 20 seconds. Hold it. Bring your arms up for spice. Some spice. Why not? Good job. Hold it. Squeeze that booty. Navel to spine. Good job. Back up. Back to the jacks. So you have the side regular jack, and then we get fancy with that front jack. I want strong arms. I want shoulders down your back. Good job. I want strong booty, strong core. Good, good, good. Good. Drop it in. So whatever leg was forward last time, switch it. I'm going to show you that profile view. I want that knee almost kissing the background. Your toes are not over your front toes. I mean, your knee is not over your front toes. Let's bring those arms up. Getting spicy. What? Good job. Keep your shoulders down your back. Squeeze that booty. Navel spine. I can't see the clock. Yes! Good job! You got a break. 20 seconds. Okay. We're gonna work our abs. We're gonna be standing up for this switch up. But I really want you to just focus on your arms. And you're gonna go up and down. It's a baby squat. Up from the side, get your mind all in here and down here. Okay, that's what it looks like. We're gonna do half and half. So up and down. Baby squat, your feet stay forward for this round. Baby squat, up and down. Squeeze that booty. Good job. Up and down. Really nice, working. Obliques, transverse, abdominis. Good job, keep those shoulders down. Switch sides. So start from up, down. Really feel that crunch in your core. Good job. Yes, up, down, up, down. Seems so basic, but you are working, especially when you have to build that resistance in your mind. You are really working your core. You could also put weights in there, a medicine ball. We're going down for regular push-ups. I just love regular basic push-ups. So hands right under your shoulders. They can be a little wider, but in that plane. And elbows go 45 degrees back. Push-up. Your body moves in one unit. Totally acceptable to be on your knees. Or using a chair. As you lift yourself from gravity, push that core away. Good job. Good. Press that ground away. God, I love push-ups. So this is a pushing exercise. We are pushing the ground away. I mean, as if you didn't know. Good job. We're going to stay right down here. Give yourself a child, please, for a second. And we are going to do Superman. So now, I want to activate the opposite muscles, your booty and your lat. So we are just gazing down to the ground. And you're just squeezing your butt, making yourself long, and again, your toes and fingers. Try not to over flex that lower back. Picture yourself making yourself long. Move that booty, get those quads off the floor. So you're squeezing up and then relaxing down. Squeezing up, relaxing down. Still, keep your knees away. Your knees away, your shoulders away from your ears. Your knees should not be anywhere near your ears. Feel that core activate, booty activate. Good job. Good job. Back to the wood chop. This time we're going to get a little deeper in that wood chop. So I want you to actually start in a side lunge bend squat thingy down here and up. So we're increasing our range of motion. Really keep your core fired up, shoulders down your back. You have a 10-pound box you're putting up on a shelf. Squeeze that booty. Good. When you go down, it's like that back knee is going straight down to the ground. One more this side. Good job. Switch sides. Start low. Press it up. Low. Press it up. Low. Up. It's okay. Your feet are moving with you on this time, this circuit. Good job. Yes, okay. We are going back down to those push-ups. This time we're running a Spider-Man leg each side in between your push-ups, okay? So find your push-ups in position, be on your knees. Bring that knee to elbow, push-up. Knee to elbow, push-up. To be in the high plank, knee to elbow, push-up. Look at your form. Body moves as one from the top of your head, down through your back, down through your butt. Good job, keep going. Spider-Man knees, do a push-up. Good. good. Give yourself a child. You know, my lower back has been bothering me a little bit, but I'm pretty convinced it's because I'm not walking at all. Okay. So, Superman, I want your thumbs up. And when you come up, your thumbs stay up, and I want you to pretend like you're pulling something down. Okay, we just did that beautiful push-up. Now we're pulling something towards us with our arms. Good job. Up and pull. Activate those lats. Back out. Keep your gaze like Superman flying over there. Up, pull down. Activate those lats. Okay, you're pulling something heavy. Create that resistance. Squeeze that booty. Good. Come stay up towards the ceiling. Good. Good. Child, close it out. Come back up. We got one more round in this circuit. We're going to hit those wood chops, but we're balancing this time. Little balance challenge in there. So start up here. Bring your opposite knee and opposite knee. You're crossing up. How's that for a word jumble? Stay right here. Try and get a little more speed. Really feel that core contract. Pretend you have 10 pounds, you have an 8-pound medicine ball in your hand. No, it's 14 pounds. Good, switch sides. That toe hits the ground and comes right back up. Twist over. If the twist hurts your back, you can go through this. Okay, otherwise, little crunch. Good. Shoulders stay down. And that was your bell. And now we're doing Spider-Man push-ups. So, that looks like your knee, every time you go down, you can be on your knees. And you go down and your knee comes up to your elbow. Okay, switch sides. You're up. You are exhaling as you push away from the ground. Good. Oh my goodness. Yes. This is a progression. Raise to the bar of the push-up game. Good job. Core is engaged. Back is flat. Woo! Good job. Come down to Superman. So, I want that lateral. I'm sorry, I want your thumbs up. Come up. Pull down. When you're down, send your arms out like a T. And then bring them forward. Come back down. Okay, I'm gonna come face you guys. So bring it up, wide, pull it back, you have that lat pull down, send your arms out to the side. You're in a T. Then bring your arms up and go back down. Thumbs up, up, pull it down, get in those lats, send those arms out to the side, you're in a T formation, come back up, or down really. Thumbs up, squeeze everything, long, pull those arms down, activate those lats, send those arms out. Good job, wrap those arms up. Thumbs up, up, pull down. I love the pull. Send arms out into a T. Beautiful. I love that. Oh my gosh, that was it. Okay, now we're gonna do a jump rope for our cardio. We got 20 seconds. So if you need to towel off or jump in the pool, do it. You got 30 seconds. Oh no, you have 15. Okay. We're gonna do some jump rope and this song's too slow. Okay. Get ready and join me at a jump rope. Jump rope. You're a really awesome jump rope right now. You can even do like double unders. You're in the CrossFit gym doing double unders. Okay. You're kicking one leg out. Whatever you want to do. You're Rocky Balboa. You're Muhammad Ali. Challenge yourself. I love the double unders that I actually can't do in real life. Or when with a jump rope, right? Side to side. You can do like one. Nice and soft on that landing. You're landing on your toes and the balls of your feet. Bounce them right back up, drop it into a squat. Drop it into a squat. Hold it. I want that booty back. Send your arms out forward. Good job. Good. You're looking forward. Your chest is proud. Your booty is back. You are just holding the squat. You have a wall next to you. You want to do a wall squat? Go for it. You do you. Good. Keep that chest proud. Don't lean over too much and that booty comes up. Keep that booty down. Chest proud. Good. Back to the jump rope. Come on. You got this. One-legged jump rope. Jump it out. Soft and soft landing. So soft. Ninja landing. You have to control that ninja landing from your core. Everything comes from your core. Shoulders are down your back. Side to side. You can pretend like you're skiing. I also can't do this when I'm skiing, which I actually don't even do. Get in that squat. Get in that squat. Find that squat. Oh, your quad should be on fire. Don't let your knees cave in. Keep them out. Send that booty back. Breathe. Breathe. Shoulders down your back. Good job. Bring those arms up. Oh, light up that. Yes, that looks so beautiful. Keep them here. Do it under 10 seconds. Get a little deeper in that squat. What? Oh, good job. Shake your legs out. Final circuit. And then one more cardio at the end. Okay. So, I really missed my bear friend last week. Not yesterday, I mean. So let's get in our bear. So bear, on all fours, one of my favorites. Hands directly underneath, shoulders, back completely flat, neutral spine. Knees come 2 inches off the ground. Hang out right here for a second. Make sure that core is activated. Make sure that back is flat. Head stays neutral. And then I want you to lift 1 foot up off the ground. Put it right back down. Lift the other foot up. Just taking your toes off the ground one at a time. Alternating. But don't load up your other side. I want that weight evenly distributed over those 3 points of contact. You really have to get your mind into your lower core, your shoulders, energy out your shoulders, down your hands if you actively are pushing the ground away. Fighting with gravity. Gravity wants those knees on the ground. Navel to spine. Beautiful. Oh, I really like this one, okay?
This is the number one champion.
Lay on your back. I'm really trying to get into your back today. So we're going to do pullovers. So I want your knees at the tabletop. I want your hands under your head. And you are pretending you have a ball and you're putting it on your tabletop legs, okay? So you're pulling over your head. I want you to pretend you got weight in your hand. Use that mind. You know how freaking powerful that mind is. Lower back is pressed into the mat. Mind over matter here. Pretend you have matter in your hands. Lower back into the mat. Beautiful. Your knees being above your hips should be pressing your lower back into the mat, but you need to activate those muscles to do the same thing. Good. Pretend you have that weight in your hands. Pull it over. Feel those lats working. Excellent. Good. Okay, where we go? Rear lunges. Good. Come on up.
American boy.
Okay. We're going to do a rear lunges. Step it back. Step it back. Good. Throw your arms in. Throw your arms in. I want that core engaged. I want that booty squeezed. I want those shoulders down your back. Again, you can pretend you have a weighted ball in your hand. Squeeze. And if you have one, use it. thing. Shoulders down your back. But you don't need it. Not right now. Good job. That knee drives straight down. I love rear lunges. I love lunges. I love a lot of exercises. Good. Beautiful. We're going back to the bear. We're taking our toes up now. We're taking our hands up too. So it's an opposite toe, opposite hand. So go into on all fours. Set up. Take your knees off the ground. Now you really like to get your mind and your muscles. Lift up a hand. Lift up a toe. Put it back down. Then if you're stabilized, you can add your feet to this. Make sure your back is flat. Make sure your core is actively engaged here. It has to be. Doing it properly, it has to be. Push that ground away. You're lifting your knee. Your knee should be off the ground. You're lifting your toe and opposite hand. And try not to move your table at all. You put those knees on the ground and go for it. You do you. Good. We're going back to those pullovers. This time, I want your legs extended. Come back. Extend so you're now nice and long. Don't let those heels touch the ground. And put that ball on the table. And take it back. Good. Extend those legs. Keep that booty. Get that core involved. Good. Shoulders away from your ears. Get those lats. Get your mind in those lats right there. As that ball comes over your head, you should feel those lats engaging your back. Good. Energy out your feet. Extend. It's like a hollow hold there. With your arms up, it's a really hard hollow hold. Beautiful. Extend over. I love these. And feet, I see the one of her exercise videos. Good job. That was excellent. Oh, the rear lunge. And we're going to hit a balance with that. Because you've got to actively work on your balance. So hit that rear lunge. And I want you to have a little speed and drive that knee up. Stay on one side. I'm sorry, I neglected to say that. Good. One side, drive that knee up, hit that balance, make sure the core is in there. Drive it up, beautiful. We have like runner's arms here. Last one on this side, switch legs. Up. Knee up to balance. Shoulders stay down your back the whole time. Try and keep that chest proud. Squeeze that booty. Almost there. Yes, navel spine. Good. Then we're back to the bears. This time, we're going into a bear extension. So it's a bird dog, really. Grab a bear. So that means getting your bear, hands under your shoulders, knees under your hips. Bring those knees off the ground, or you can keep them on the ground. And you're extending opposite leg, opposite foot. But this is circuit three. So challenge yourself. In that challenge, as long as you're in form, that is where the strength is. That's where you build strength, which we're doing. And everybody's challenge point is going to be a little different. Good. Try to keep that back as flat as possible. You have a whole dinner on your back. Keep it flat. Neutral spine. Good job. So we were doing those lat pullovers. So now I want you to try and do a hand free tuck. Okay, so you bring your knees in, or you do a V sit. Super hard. I go between the two. See, I'm so like my nemesis. That's why I gotta put him in though, right? Ah. Good job. Good job. Stop lower. Knees come in. Back is completely off the ground. Good job! I will get the upside in this for more than two in a row. Okay, we have that rear lunge. This is our last move in circuit three. Then we have one more cardio. Rear lunge, five pulses up to balance. Rear lunge, one, two, three, four, five, up. Stay on that same side. Two, three, four, five, up. Pulse it, one, two, three, four, five, up. Good job, pulse. Squeeze that booty, up. One, two, three, four, five, up. Switch legs. One, two, three, four, five, up. Squeeze that butt, shoulders down, up. Four, five, beautiful. Keep going under 10 seconds. Up, two, three, four, five, up. One more. One, two, three, four, five, up. Oh, your quads are on fire. Okay, good job. That was circuit three. We have one more little cardio thing. But you know what I wanna do? Oh, no, I won't do this now. Okay, we're gonna do woman makers. So it's not so much cardio, it's a little bit of cardio. So a woman maker is a push-up, okay? If you have weights, you do one row, then I want your feet to jump in and up, that's one. So we're gonna do that, join me right now. Get in that push-up position, you thought they were all done. But I love them and they love you. So push-up, row one arm up, row the other arm up, bring those feet in, press it up, back down. So you got squat in there. Then a push-up, a row, pop those feet in, press it up. Like a burpee push-up marriage. Good. Row, feet in, press it up, yes. Back, you're holding a low plank. So get on those forearms. You can have your knees on the ground, but your knees are up. But your booty is tucked and engaged. Energy out those shoulders, pushing the ground away. Head is neutral. You got energy popping out of everything here. Lower belly is engaged. Good job. So back to those woman makers. Get to that high plank. Push it up. Row. Legs pop in. Press up. Down. Row. Feet pop in. Squat back down. Good job. That push up, whether you have your knees on the ground or not, your butt is not in the air. You're moving as one. Row. Feet jump in. Press it up. You got two hand weights. You go for get that low plank. And into your rows. And end into that jump squat press. Low plank. Squeeze that booty. Energy out your shoulders and your elbows. Push the floor away. Strong back. Neutral spine. Don't let your head dip. Keep going. You got this. You are under 10 seconds. Good. Yes. Good child. You're done. We're going to stretch it out. Hold on. With that child pose. Send those knees out a little bit. Energy out your fingers. Take one hand, thread it through. Let's do that. Oh, yeah. Thread it under your arm. Here's your scratch and sniff. Look at those fingers underneath. Woo! Let your head rest. Really good job. I really like that workout because it's sneaky. Switch arms. I like sneaky workout. Oh, look at that hand that you threaded through. Try and grab the floor a little bit. Pull that arm under more. Good job. Pull that. Bring that arm back. Come up to cat. Cat. Oh, give me a cat. Now look up to the ceiling. Tailbone up. Cow. Cat. Cow. Good job. Do that 90. That we did this yesterday. Tuck that booty under. So one knee is up to 90-90. Meaning one knee is directly under your hip, one leg is straight out in front. Just tuck that booty so you feel a hip flexor stretch right here. Good job. I want you to rest your forearm on that front leg. Put one hand down, ground. Send that back leg up. Six forward. And I want you, the leg that's up, put the hand on top of it. Open up that chest. So you're turning into that front leg. Look up to the ceiling. Good job. Bring it back down. Bring that other leg in. Send that booty up into the air. Bring that, bend that booty back and send that other leg back. Do the opener first. Send that arm up. Open that back up. It's the same. Feel it in your glutes. Open that chest. Good job. I don't want to forget this hip flexor. So bring that knee down to the ground. Send that booty forward. You're in 90-90 again. Opposite butt cheek. Push it forward. I love this stretch. Because it's like, it doesn't look like you're stretching. Get that hip flexor. Okay, bring that leg in. Roll it up. Good. Shoulders last, head last. Take deep breath in. Our butts are getting strong. So hot, I'm gonna take my clothes off. I hope you liked it.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Tara. Thank you.
Thanks, Sarah. Hey, you need a smile.
Thanks, Sarah.
Love you guys.
Thanks, Sarah.
If anyone wants to hang out, I'm doing a couple shoulder back moves today. I'm really into the
Thank
shoulders
you.
And back. If you have lightweights, bye, Michelle. Hi, Sylvia.
Bye, Dada.
Oh. Okay, let me see what we got.
Hey, John.
Okay, we're actually going to do the pullovers with weights. Bye, JD. Or hi, JD. Are you staying? Are you going? Hi, Lawrence.
So,
hold on. I got to get one thing. Hold on. All right. So there's laterals in there, so I like to do lighter weights with that. We're gonna go back on the ground for those pullovers. I'm gonna mute you guys. Oh, that's the wrong thing, I always do that. Okay, I'm gonna mute you. And we're gonna hit these abs. We're gonna do three exercises. We'll do 10 reps each. Sometimes I throw in an extra rep, and then we'll do it three times.
So, first one, we're going back on the ground. I want, grab your weight. I'm gonna have one weight in my hand and it's gonna be over my head. We're gonna do that lat pullover that we did in class, but this time we're gonna do it with weights. So get on your back flat and you can bring your knees up. However you like to lay down, you can have them on the ground, totally fine. I like when they're up, I feel that, hold on, I can't see that, okay. I feel that my back gets nice and flat to the ground. So I just want, your arms overhead, try, and you are literally just pulling over, okay? And it gets right into your lat muscles. Press into that weight, whatever you're holding, that's three. I love this exercise. Four, five, because I love strengthening everything. Six, but sometimes your lats are hard to get into. Because it's a hard muscle to even envision, which I'll show it to you when we get up here. Let's do four more. Four. three. I want your core activated. Two. One. Good job. We're going to come back up. Now we're going to do a frontal lateral, which I really love. So as you're, when you stand, I want your feet, they can be hip width apart. Nice, strong core, boot, soft knee. This means a little bend. That helps activate your glutes. Then it helps activate your core. Your shoulders are rolled down your back. And we are literally just going up and then to the side. I want a soft elbow. Two, that's one. Good. Keep those shoulders down your back. That's two. Squeeze that core. Squeeze that booty. That's three. And ladies, I don't necessarily do heavy weights because when your arms extended like that, four, it's very hard and easy to lose form and use, try and use momentum to get those weights up, which you don't want any momentum here. You want your shoulders to do this. That's five. Squeeze that booty, squeeze that core. Six. Good. Nice neutral spine. Seven. Good. Core is engaged. Please get into your back on that lateral too. Good. Get the mind of your muscles. Last one right there. Good. We're actually going to go back down to the ground and we're going to do a high plank pull. I want it. So this is your lat muscles right here. It's a funky little thing between your shoulder and your arm, your ribs. So I want a high plank. I want one heavy weight. If you don't have, if you're working with bands, Ange, you can do the row. That's also going to get into your lats. If you want to put it around your hands and row it up. Otherwise, I want you in a high plank. I want the weight behind your wrist. Okay, again, you could be on your knees, you could be up here. Energy's out your hands, and you are literally pulling it from one side to the other. You can have a nice wide base. That's one, one pull through. But this, when you're pulling that through, I want that core fired up. Then picture your lats doing the work. Keep those hands under your shoulders. Pull it through. Good. Do not move your hips. If your hips are moving, put your knees on the ground. I want stabilized hips. Good job. Keep going. Let's do five. Four. Three. Two. You're breathing. One more pull through. Good. Why don't we just stay on the ground and do that lat pullover? We are in our backs today. I love it. Okay. You choose your weight if you have choices. And I want that arm overhead. And we can even do the leg extension that we did in class. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. Don't let that weight touch the ground. Six, two more. Nine, ten. Good job. Back up to the shoulders. Oh, I like this. I like it. Tomorrow we'll work the biceps good. Okay. So you have those soft knees. Hip, toes are forward. Knees are right above your ankles. Right under your hips. Get ready. One. Soft elbow. Shoulders are down your back. That's one. Two. Make sure you're breathing. Three. Squeeze that booty. Four, five, six, relax that neck, seven, ooh, I feel it, 8, squeeze that butt, squeeze that core. 9, no momentum. Just your raw strength. Good job. We're gonna do that high plank pull through. So again, if you have bands, you can put them on your hands and do that row up. And that's gonna get, your triceps is gonna get into your lats. Okay, but if you have the weight, put it right behind your wrist. Set up that high plank. You can even like set it out to the side a little bit. You can be on your knees, just tuck that booty. Otherwise your knees are up off the ground and you're pulling through. Do not move your hips. That's 1, 2, 3. Core is so involved in this. 4. I think that was 4. 5, 6, 7. 8, 9. Oh, do one more. Yes, good. One more with that lat pull over. Hold on a second, if my battery's gonna die. Hold on. Sorry. That would be tragic. Oh my gosh. Hold on. Okay, I'm back. Technical difficulties. Okay. Here we go. So lay on your back. Grab that weight. And let's do that leg extension one again. Or you can do the one with your legs up. It's your call. Okay, I don't want that weight touching the back ground behind you. And just pull it over. 2, 3, you can have your head on the ground. 4, 5, lower back in the mat. Get your mind in those lats. 6, I think that was 7, but we'll say 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, do 2 more here, the last one. Oh, and what I love about that, you can move your legs in and out and feel different parts of your muscles working and your core as well. Okay, frontal lateral. So nice up, hip width apart, knees over your ankles, squeeze that booty, shoulders down, little bend in those elbows, and up and out for 1, and up and out for 2, and up, squeeze that butt. 3, shoulders down your back. 4, soften in those elbows. No momentum. All strength. 5, I think. 5, 6, good. 7, you got this. 1 more. 1, hold it up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Bring it down and go out to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good job. Okay, last one, our high plank pull through. Oh, we gotta get the shoulder low. Okay. So find that. Beautiful high plank, hands under shoulders, booty squeeze, core tight, pull that weight through. And back to the other side. That's 1, 2, don't move those hips. The further you pull that weight through, as you reach for it, you'll feel those lats get involved. 3, 4, don't move your hips. 5, squeeze, no hip movement. 6, 10. Good job. Come on up. Woo. You have a wall close by. Stretch your arm out against that wall, but we could do this. Bring it over. Gotta stretch those shoulders out a little bit. Good. Other one. Ooh, give your wrists some love. They did a lot of work too. Good, let's bring it back. Oh my goodness. That's a shoulder back workout. That was lovely. Switch arms. Good job. Thank you, guys.